Hello. Welcome back to Knitting Between the Lines. This is a knitting and reading podcast. My name is Mia, and I'm coming to you live from the mountains of Western North Carolina, where it's finally feeling like winter. The weather has been all over the place the last couple months. That is a reality of living in North Carolina. And we're finally getting some cold weather. So I'm finally wearing some hand knits. I'm finishing up some hand knits. I've been doing a lot of reading, been very cozy, and I'm very excited to update you all. It's been 2 months since I released an episode. That was not intentional. The holidays were a little crazy, as I'm sure they might've been for you. And I was a little stressed, and I needed time to rest, essentially. And I'm glad I took that time because I have more to show you because of it. I didn't do a lot of knitting around the holidays. I was very busy and I spent a lot of time playing on my Switch. So made a lot of progress on Disney Dreamlight Valley, but didn't do as much knitting. I kind of went through like a knitting slump towards the end of December, beginning of January, and then I picked it back up. So now that I've picked it back up, I have more things to show you, more things to share. Hopefully the glare isn't too bad in my glasses because I'm getting some glare, but hopefully we are okay. Today I am drinking a cup of tea. I'm drinking the Sewrella's, I think it's Autumn Harvest. I've had it for a while. It's a very good tea. I'm drinking it out of this World Market mug, and I'm using this little tea infuser with a very pretty like chakra stone heart that my friend Julia gifted me for Christmas. And that is what I'm sipping on. So buckle in. I hope you have a warm beverage, maybe a snack, or you're knitting to watch along. So yeah, let's start off with finished objects. If it's not obvious, I finished my nostalgia tee. I am wearing it. So this is my finished nostalgia tee. I am very pleased with it. Very, very pleased with it. I'm gonna like get seated in a comfortable position now. I like to sit with my legs or one leg up. Anyway. So this is it. This is the finished tee. I finished it earlier this week and cast it off, and I blocked it, and I'm very happy with it. Couple notes on it. It did bloom a little bit with blocking, but not too bad. Thinking back, I do have short arms, so I kind of wish I had done like one less color work repeat to get the true like 3/4 length sleeve, but I do like the sleeve length on it, so I'm not upset. I'm very pleased with it. It is very pretty. If you have been following along since I cast this on in October, I think, I was unsure about the colors because when I got the yarn at SAF, this pink looked more red. And then I got home and I was like, oh no, that's pink. But I'm very pleased with it. So I really like how it turned out. The yarn is Seaside Fiber Arts. And the colors are, oh, I have them here, but I have already forgotten. I use Sequoia, Henna, and Walaba wood. I believe the pink is Sequoia and the light brown is the Henna. And I think the white is the Walaba wood. So, or Guyana, it's also called, I think. So I think those are the colors, but I haven't thought about that in a while. So I forget which are which. So yeah, that's the finished nostalgia tee, and I'm very pleased with it. It's a good color. It's very pretty. It's very, I don't know, I'm staring at it in my phone right now. It's just very pretty. I really like how it turned out. This is by Bloom and Create, by the way, the pattern. And yeah, very nice. I liked it so much that I also started on a pair of matching socks, and we'll get to that in a minute. But before we do that, I do want to show you my finished Christmas socks. So my last episode went up at the beginning of December, and I was unsure if I was going to be doing Christmas socks. I didn't have anything planned. I couldn't find a pattern. I didn't have a yarn. I had started working on just a pair of socks with some yarn I got at SAF, and I actually ended up undoing those. I ended up ripping those back, frogging those back. So I did do a pair of Christmas socks because I participated in the Winter Wishes sock swap with La Mercerie. This was my second year doing it. And my lovely partner sent me the most beautiful yarn from Sewrella, the Tchaikovsky colorway, which is one I've had my eye on for years. And they included it as part of a collab with some small yarn, or not small, but just, you know, yarn dyer, indie yarn dyers for the Winter Wishes sock swap. So she got me the Tchaikovsky colorway with the contrasting color, and I made Christmas socks with them, and I just finished these a couple weeks, a week or so ago. And then it's probably been 2 weeks, and then it took me like a week to get the energy to block them, and I literally just pulled them off. They're blocking like mold things. So here they are. I did the, what's the pattern? The Christmas Eve Hygge sock pattern on Ravelry by Hygge Canyon Knits. This is gonna be a very Hygge episode. We can talk more about that in a minute. So this is what they look like. It's like alternating pearl and knit stitches with a really pretty tree at the top. And then this kind of ladder looking stitch going all the way down. I wasn't aware when I first started knitting them that this colorway was gonna be very self-striping. I looked it up on Ravelry, and some people's looked striped and some people's didn't with socks, and mine ended up very self-striping. So it doesn't take away from the pattern I'm trying to get them. They literally just stop blocking. So I'm trying to get them flat for you. But I don't think it takes away from the pattern too much. It makes it a little more subtle, but they did end up really just self-striping down. And here's like the back where you can really see the colors. So beautiful. I do not know what the contrasting color is for these, but it is also very pretty and goes all the way down. And I haven't even worn them yet. I'm probably gonna throw them on today. It's still winter time. I mean, they're just winter trees. So these I might use outside of just Christmas. But yeah, that's the finished socks. And I'm very pleased with them. I really like the detail. You do a row of pearl right after the cuff, and then you also do it throwing them around. You also do that row of pearl right before the toe. And I really like how it turned out. So they're very pretty and I like them. And it's a gorgeous colorway. So I worked on these through December, didn't quite get them finished until about mid-January, maybe late January, and yeah, it's probably late January, and I blocked them. So now we're gonna wear them today because it is cold today. It's finally cold, cold enough to wear hand knit socks. I haven't been wearing a lot of hand knits because it hasn't been quite, especially hand knit socks, it just hasn't been quite cold enough. But now we're getting to where it's colder outside, which is exciting because that means I get to wear more hand knits. Okay, so those are my two finished objects. Very excited, I'm gonna wear them both today. I keep looking at this sweater, it's absolutely stunning. Emma is an amazing, amazing designer. She has a new sweater pattern that's coming out very soon, if it hasn't already by the time this goes up. And I might have to cast that on. So that's my finished objects. Let's jump into my whips and what I'm currently working on. So since I already kind of mentioned them, let's look at my nostalgia socks. So in case you didn't know, Emma of Bloom and Create, she really kind of blew up with designs with doing colorwork socks. And her colorwork socks are phenomenal. She got me into knitting colorwork socks. She really got me into knitting colorwork in general. And she designed a while back a pair of socks called the Nostalgia Socks, and the design is influenced by friendship bracelets you'd make at summer camp as a kid. And then those socks were so popular and she loved them so much, she made a sweater pattern. So the sweater pattern is literally like the same motif as the socks. And I'm 99% sure enough yarn left over to make a pair to match my sweater. So I started these a couple days ago. And that's how it's looking. I'm matching the colors the same. I thought about doing kind of an inverted version and doing like white is my main color or the tan is my main color, but I decided to go full on matching. So that's what they look like after just one round there of, or like kind of half a round of the color work chart. And I wanted to show you my little stitch marker. This was also gifted to me during the Winter Wishes sock swap. There we go. And it is so, how do I show it to you? It is so cute. It's a little spare sock. There it is. It's so cute. It's perfect for sock knitting. So I just started these. I don't know if I'm gonna do the full leg length on them that the pattern calls for. I might do a little shorter just to be careful with the amount of yarn, but also just because it's February. There's not much time left where I will be able to wear hand knit socks, and I don't know if I want to have them like higher up for boots. I might just do kind of shorter legs on them. So those are my nostalgia socks. So I love having socks on the needles at all times. My next whip is actually one I started probably about a month ago, and it's something I've been wanting to do. I have quite a bit of scrap yarn, quite a bit of scrap sock yarn from knitting a bunch of socks, and just there's the dryer. When there will come a day where I do film one of these podcasts and I don't have things on the dryer. Today is not that day. Anyway, I knit a lot with fingering weight yarn. I like fingering weight yarn. It's my favorite. This was fingering weight. I just love it. And so I have a lot of scraps, and some of my scraps are like not, I don't have enough of them to do certain scrappy patterns or anything like that. So my friend Claire has been working on a northeasterly blanket for a couple years now. It's a long project with scrap sock yarn or scrap fingering weight yarn. And I finally took the plunge and started a northeasterly blanket. It's by Skynanigans on Ravelry. I think it's a pretty well-known scrap yarn pattern. And it's kind of just to decide as you go, design, decide, create as you go with scrap sock yarn, which I like, because you don't need to have a certain amount of each color. You don't need, So this is a current whip. I haven't touched it in a couple of weeks because I was working on finishing up my sweater, but this is what it's looking like. And I am gonna try and make a full blanket. So I think for the full blanket in the pattern, it recommends doing like a certain number of columns. And I'm not quite there yet. This, I have a feeling, is gonna be, when I started it, I was like, this will probably be a year-long project. And then I like saw Claire post about hers, and I remember seeing her like in person when she came up to Western North Carolina pre-COVID, and she had just started her blanket. So hers has been 3 years in the making. So now I'm kind of like, this might be a 5-year project, especially if I don't have enough scrap yarn on hand right now. I have a lot of scrap yarn, but I'm not sure if it's enough for a full-size blanket. So this might be something that like I truly take years to work on and build up the yarn for. But I'm not gonna go through and let you know what yarn is what, because I am entirely unsure. Some of this yarn I've had for 5 or 6 years. But if you leave a comment, you want to know a specific color, I will do my best to tell you. For all my other projects and everything, I do list everything down below. I list the pattern links, I list, the yarn, everything like that. So if you do have any questions about, other projects, it's all below. So yeah, this is another whip. I don't know if this is one I'm going to show in every podcast episode going forward, because, that might get very redundant after 5 years or something if I do this podcast for that long. But I am working on a northeasterly blanket, and I'm very excited because I'd love to have a hand knit blanket with fingering weight yarn. It's already very nice to the touch. It's small, it's in no way a blanket yet, but it's very nice to just to the touch. I really, really love it. Okay, my last whip is crochet, which is a refresher. It's a refresher because I haven't crocheted anything in quite a while. And if you've watched any of my previous episodes, you might be able to guess what it is. And I took a flat lay for Instagram earlier today. And first of all, I forgot to include my socks in it. So that's that. My Christmas Eve hygge socks. But I also messed up the yarn, the cake of yarn for this sweater. So I'm trying to, pull it out without tangling it worse. I finally started the Kelly Crew neck. Finally, I received this yarn. I pre-ordered this yarn from Sewrella, the Autumn in New York collection. This is the Autumn in New York colorway, and I pre-ordered sweater quantity for the Kelly crew neck, which was designed by Two of Wands. And I received that back in like October or November, and I just started it. So it is a crocheted kind of boxy sweater. I'm gonna try and show you without losing my stitch here, but that is how it looks. And I'm really loving how this colorway looks crocheted up. It is so pretty. So yeah, I have really been enjoying it. It's very soft to the touch. This is, I believe it's sport weight. I think I have a tag in here. Yeah, so it's the classic sport. It's 100% superwash merino wool. So it's very soft to the touch. And the coloring is just so pretty on it. And I'm very, very excited. Oh, and I have even more exciting news. For the first time ever with a sweater, I did a swatch. Hold your applause. Hold your applause. I did a swatch. So I did swatch it. My gauge is pretty on point. I'm a slightly looser crocheter and like slightly tighter knitter. But my gauge is pretty on point for the pattern. So there's my swatch. And here is, I believe this is the back of it. So yeah, that's how it's looking. And I did, when I ordered or pre-ordered this, I did get one of her crochet hooks. I don't know if you can read that. It says Sewrella yarn on it. It is very nice to crochet with. The handle here is very soft to the touch. So very like ergonomic almost, and just its design. So it is very nice to crochet with. It's been a nice breath of fresh air to be, here I am just working on it, to be crocheting something. I forget how easy, it's so easy. And this is such a mindless pattern. I can set it down whenever and just pick it back up whenever. And it's so easy to just get carried away with watching TV. I've been binging a lot of stuff on the weekends, which is how I like finished this sweater. I think I finished it while I binged House of the Dragon a couple weekends ago. And that is how I had like an Indiana Jones movie marathon last weekend. This is how I've been finishing things the last couple weeks. So yes, so it's absolutely stunning and I'm very excited. I'm probably not gonna have it done in time to wear it this season. But here's to hoping I do. Let's see. So I think that's actually it for my knitting. Although I did wanna show you one other thing that I got. It's for my stitch markers, cause I have quite a few stitch markers and they weren't organized the best. And I often found myself like mid project needing a stitch marker and having to dig through my pot or like my Notions bag or something like that. And then I was on TikTok, and I can spend way too much time on there sometimes. And I was on TikTok and I got a video of, it was like an aesthetic ASMR video, but it was a woman just packed my purse with me to go out, and she's putting all this kind of unnecessary stuff in her purse. But she had one of these containers. And of course everything was from Amazon, and I saw this container and I was like, that would actually be perfect for stitch markers. So here it is. I got it in cream. I will link it below. And I put a little knit collage sticker that I had on it. And it's magnetic closure. I think it's for pills, but I'm using it for stitch markers. I don't have anything in here yet. So I'm using it for stitch markers. I kind of have them somewhat organized. And that is how I'm holding my stitch markers now. The only ones that aren't in here are my little bitty delight ones, which are, I think they're clay. They're little miniature foods. I tried to put them in here, but I had too many and they're a little too bulky to all have fit in here. I'm very proud of my little bitty delights stitch marker collection, but that's how I'm holding all my other ones. It's very nice. It's very compact, magnetic closure. You can see these close really well too. They snap closed. So yeah, and it was like maybe $10. I don't know. Very pleased with it. It's like a little miniature tackle box for my knitting, for my stitch markers. And take another sip of tea. And we're gonna talk about reads now. So now we are transitioning over to the reading portion of Knitting Between the Lines, to talk about things I have been reading, things I have finished reading, things I plan to read. And we might finish off this episode since we are in a new year and I haven't spoken to you all since 2022. Yes, I had to think about what year it was. Might talk to you about some like of my plans for 2023 with knitting and with reading. So we might still have a little bit of knitting sprinkled in at the end here, but I have been reading a lot of really good stuff recently. I have been on a reading kick, and it's been great. So in the month of December, I did read The Atlas Six, and I read it on my Kindle, so I don't have a physical copy here to show you, but I did read The Atlas Six. Chef's kiss, loved it. It's adult kind of fantasy. I reviewed it on my Instagram. I do review books on my Instagram. If you are interested, and I have a highlight with all the books that I have read since I started doing that. It is everything I wanted a KOTAR to be. A Court of Thorns and Roses. Yes, that series. The Atlas Six was everything I wanted that series to be. I have a lot of mixed feelings about that series. I have a lot of mixed feelings about it. It's not my favorite. I do not understand the hype. Maybe that is a controversial take. I'm sorry. The Atlas Six was phenomenal. I absolutely loved it. It was a great book. It had a lot of Dark Academia vibes. It was kind of Hunger Games-ish with like Harry Potter kind of vibes. So really, 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 really loved it. Devoured that month of December. I also read, because Colton, my partner, got this for me for Christmas, My Hygge Home by Mike Wiking. So, some ASMR. So yes, I read My Hygge Home. Really, really good book. I've started getting more interested in the concept of hygge. I've known what hygge is for years. And I've kind of, to some extent, practiced that in my regular life for years, just being cozy and enjoying coziness. I'm a knitter. I'm in library school. I read. I naturally gravitate to cozy things. I was kind of interested in reading just more about the concept of hygge, and so this was really good. If you're not familiar with what hygge is, it's a Danish word, and there's not a direct translation for it in English, but this is just off the top of my head, so forgive me if this definition is not quite on point. Basically defines things that are cozy, but the feeling of coziness, and yeah, it's like things that are cozy, the feeling and the ambiance of coziness, all that stuff. And I believe the word is used like as a verb as well as like an adjective, and I think so. Mike Wiking goes more in depth in this book about it. So it was very good. This was a wonderful morning read. I really got into it. The pictures are really pretty. It's a quick read because I'm trying to find you a good. Here we go. Because, you know, the font is a little larger. It's a coffee table book. So, and it is sitting on my coffee table. So I really enjoyed it. This was a great book. So much so that I bought his other book. I kind of read them out of order because I think this is his second one. But I did buy his other book. We'll get to that in a minute. What I am currently reading, I'm currently reading the sequel to The Atlas Six, which is The Atlas Paradox. I'm also reading that on Kindle. I'm really enjoying it so far. I haven't gotten through it quite as quickly as the first one. It might be a little longer. I'm not sure. It's hard to tell when you're reading on Kindle because you don't have like a physical book. I don't look at page numbers, so it might be a little bit longer. But I also just back at work. I'm back at school. I'm not having as much time in the evenings to wind down and read. So I've been reading like maybe a chapter a night. So I'm going through it a little slower, but I'm really enjoying it. I also hopped on the bandwagon and I'm reading Spare by Prince Harry. I'm fairly certain he had a ghostwriter for this, but I am reading Spare. I'm roughly, not quite, but almost halfway through. I was really timid. I'm going to set this down because I'm not going to lie, his stare is unnerving. I was really timid to buy this book. I was definitely interested in it and wanted to read more about it. I'm very interested. It's a niche interest of mine is the British royal family history, like, and current happenings, things like that. So I have been very interested in everything that's been going on with them as of recent. I hosted a live watch party for Harry and Meghan's wedding back in 2018? Live, like US time live. So like it started at like 3 a.m. So yeah, that's a little embarrassing to admit. Only one of my friends showed up, but it was fine. We had scones and tea and cucumber sandwiches at 3 a.m. So yes, I was very timid to buy because obviously I watched the Oprah interview. I watched the Netflix docuseries. I'm like, what else is there to read about? Plus with a lot of memoirs, I just prefer to listen to them on audiobook. But we went to, Colton and I went to Barnes & Noble to get the little book of Hygge because I wanted to buy it about a month ago. And of course, this was front and center. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to buy it. And you know what? I'm really enjoying it. It's very good. There's moments of tone deafness as to be expected, but not as much as you'd think there'd be. But again, I'm not quite halfway through yet. So I am enjoying it. I think I'm still in the middle of him talking about his time with the army. It's been about a week since I picked it up. But even that is very interesting to read about. Just getting more perspective on his time in, I believe, Afghanistan. I could be wrong. I probably should have reviewed before I started talking about this book. But it's interesting, and it's written in a really easy way to read for me. So it's been pretty good. This also sits on the coffee table, and I need to just flip it over because it's so unnerving. Anyway, so I have been enjoying it. We'll give a full review when I finish it. I feel like there's something else. Oh, but I was gonna mention, one thing that's nice about it is the chapters are very short. Like, they're almost like vignettes. So they're like, the longest one I read was maybe 3 pages long. So it's a really easy book to pick up and put down, which is nice. Okay, so that's what I'm currently reading, but I wanted to show you a couple other books because I received some for Christmas and then I bought some and I have plans because there are a lot of books that have or will be coming out. I think they've already all been released that I have been wanting to read. And so I have like solid reading plans for this year. So the first is, I have a whole stack of books here, please forgive me, The Little Book of Hygge. I bought this thinking I was going to read it immediately, and then I started reading Spare. I felt like it was more timely to start reading Spare. So, but there's our guy, Mike. And, yeah, so this is just, I'm not even quite sure. The Danes are famously the happiest people in the world, and Hygge is a cornerstone of their way of life. Hygge loosely translates as a sense of comfort, togetherness, and well-being. Here's your translation. You know Hygge when you feel it. It is when you are cuddled up on a sofa with a loved one or sharing comfort food with your closest friends. So I think this is just a general book. I think it includes some recipes or like foods. And a little bit maybe on decor and design, but the Hygge Home was definitely about creating a Hygge space in your home. This I think is just more general, but I am excited to read it. That's probably gonna be one of my next reads. I kind of have my nighttime reads in bed, which are on Kindle, and then I have my morning reads, especially for weekend mornings. Spare is my current morning read. Like while I'm drinking my coffee, and then I think The Little Book of Hygge is going to follow that. Then we have The Midnight Library, which was gifted to me for Christmas. This is a book I've wanted to read for years and I just haven't. So I asked for it for Christmas. And I don't know when I'm gonna start it, but I am definitely going to read it this year. And I am excited. I wanted to show you this bookmark that my dad's partner brought back from England. And it is so pretty. And it has this really pretty tassel. So she gifted me that from England, and that is in my book to read eventually. Another book I bought that I'm not going to read this year, maybe, because I've already read it. I read it years ago, but it's Anna and the French Kiss by Stephanie Perkins. Stephanie Perkins is a local author to me. She's also a former librarian. I remember also looking at the pages. And this book came out like in 2011, 2012, because I read it shortly after it came out when I was in high school. And I actually had a signed copy of it from a local bookstore because she had done a reading. And I don't know what I did with that signed copy. I don't have it. I don't know what happened to it. I might have given it away. I don't know. I purge things. Like, I will purge things. And sometimes I will purge things without thinking, like, twice. And I think that's what happened. And then I regret it. Anyway. But this is, like, a special, I think it's the 10th anniversary edition. And it was just stunning. And it was at Barnes & Noble. And I have been thinking about getting the 10th anniversary edition of this book for quite a while. So it was there, so I bought it. And it's very pretty on my bookshelf. And I might read it. I might do like a reread or something of it. Before I show you my last book, I want to talk about some of my reading plans for 2023 in case any of these books sound appealing to you. So the first one is Hellbent by Leigh Bardugo. Yes, I said her name right, I think. I hope so. I have been looking forward to Hellbent for like 2 years now since I read The Ninth House. It is the sequel to The Ninth House, and it came out, I think, in January of this year. So it just came out. And I've been looking forward to it. So I'm excited to read it. Leigh Bardugo, if you recognize her name, she wrote The Six of Crows and the Grisha series, which I also read. Very good. Ninth House is a little more adult. It's adult. It's adult fantasy. It covers very dark themes. So I wouldn't recommend it. It covers themes like essay and things like that. So it's very dark, but it was very, very good. So I've been looking forward to Hellbent. And that just recently came out. I'm also wanting to read Hex You by PC and Kristen Cast. That is the newest book in their Sisters of Salem series. Those are very good light reads. I love PC and Kristen Cast. I read the entirety of their House of Night series in middle school and high school. And I wish I owned those books still, but I don't, because it was like a 12 or 13 book series and I think I gave them all away. But I did read the entirety of that series in middle school and high school. And so their writing, even though it is cheesy, holds a special place in my heart. So the newest Sisters of Salem book, Hex You, I think also just recently came out. And so I'm wanting to read that soon. There's a new book called The Paris Apartment by Lucy Foley that has caught my eye a couple times in bookstores that I think is kind of loosely on my to-be-read list. It is kind of like a mystery crime book. I should have pulled up the like back cover descriptions for these, but I didn't, so I apologize. But I will link them and their Goodreads like descriptions and stuff. I'm also on Goodreads, so I'll link all that below so you can go click and read more on your own time. And then I'll plan to read a new Stephen King book this year. I have kind of a part of my yearly reading goals. I always like to read a Stephen King book. I started that back in 2019. So I'll need to add a Stephen King book to my list this year. If you have any suggestions, please let me know. I read Pet Sematary last year, really loved it. I think it was my favorite thus far. The year before that, I read A Girl Who Loves Tom Gordon, or Who Loved Tom Gordon, The Girl Who Loved Tom Gordon. I read that, it was very good too. And the year before that, I read The Shining, which was also really good, very long. So if you have any suggestions, I'm open to really any of his books. Obviously I like his writing, short or long, it's fine. Maybe not It. I don't think I'm ready to read It. That's just too long of a book to commit to. But yeah, so I'm open to any suggestions. I'm also going to try and keep up the habit of reading a book in Spanish and reading a book in French. Every year I fell off that this last year, but I'm gonna try and get back into that. In case you didn't know, I studied Spanish and French in college. Spanish was my major, French was my minor. So just to keep up my language skills, I like to try and read a book. It doesn't have to be strictly like a French book from France. It could literally be a translated edition of something, but just something in those languages to keep up my skills. And those are my plans, my reading plans for this year. To talk about knitting plans really quickly before I hop off for today, I did also for Christmas receive the Charming Colorwork Socks knitting pattern book by Stone Knits. and it is absolutely gorgeous. So I do plan to knit at least something out of here this year. Ooh, the tulips one is so pretty. So there's a lot of very pretty socks in here. I don't think, no, I haven't knit anything stone knits yet, but I have been, I stalk her Ravelry page at least once a week. So yeah, the lavender one is really, really pretty here. So I'm hoping to knit something out of here soon-ish. Might do some lavender socks for spring. But in terms of other patterns, I've had my eye on the Bronte socks, which is a Sewrella pattern. They're just very pretty for just a solid color yarn sock, which I haven't done in a while. Just like literally just a solid color, no speckle, nothing, no color work. It's very pretty. I think I talked about this in my last episode, but Andrea Mowry's new Big Cozy Cardi has my name all over it, and I have not stopped thinking about it since she released it back in like November. So I think that's gonna be my next big thing as the Big Cozy Cardi, because I really wanna make that. And I've also had my eye on the Pressed Flowers shawl by Amy Christoffers on Ravelry. You've probably seen it. It was very popular this last year, and I have also been thinking about that nonstop for almost a year. So might end up doing that. So those are just kind of my loose knitting plans or want to knits for 2023. But yeah, I have talked for 35 minutes. And if you have stayed this long, I really appreciate you coming here and listening to everything that I had to say about knitting and crocheting and reading and tea and the like. So thank you if you stayed this long. And I appreciate you, and I appreciate you staying. And if you have any knitting plans or reading plans for 2023, let me know what they are in the comments below. I'd love to swap pattern ideas, knitting plans, reading plans, books. Love to swap ideas. So let me know in the comments, and I will be seeing you next month. Who knows what next month's episode's gonna be like with this huge stack of books and my three whips. It might be a little crazy. But anyway, have a wonderful rest of your February. Happy Valentine's Day. It's one of my favorite holidays. And I'll be seeing you in a month. Okay, bye.